It was so easy that night. Should have been strong, yeah, I lied. Nobody gets.
Okay, so I finally got round to do this video. Lou has left the house for the first time in God knows how long and left me alone. So I can finally get this to your hat. So, right, I've got all these questions and Jesus Christ, I feel like I'm on Mastermind with this, but here goes. So first thing I noticed about Lou, I would say her, so we met at uni. I remember she was always very bubbly, laughy, gotta be that laugh, 100%, it is that cackle that used to just fill a room and send everyone else silent or make them burst out laughing. So that's definitely the first thing that I noticed about her. The most annoying habit, so easy, is her nose slash mouth slash allergies slash the weird noise that she makes when she's like all the time. God knows what is wrong with her nose, but it is horrendous. And I'm sure half the street hear her all the time, so that's definitely our most annoying thing. Pet names for each other. I don't think we really have any soppy things or anything like that. She's called, I call her Dubon, which I have no idea where that's come from, but that's stuck and I call her that. So get rid of one item of clothing of Lou's, which is hard to narrow it down because her clothes are out there, let's say. So there's one item that I'm not sure if she's got rid of it actually, so I think I've been successful in managing to bin this. It was this big pink puffer dress thing that she had. It was horrendous. She looked like a toilet doily, like this little queen lady that sat on it. I remember we wore it around France once and everyone just was looking at her and was like, what the hell is this outfit? Yeah, it was out there, rather weird. She seemed to love it and didn't care, but yeah, I hated it. Most embarrassing couple story. I'm not sure if we've got any as a couple that have been embarrassing. I think we've got one we're together, but they usually revolve around Lou needing to stop for a wee somewhere. So I think one of the best examples of this is when we went out for a nice romantic walk. We'd driven into the Yorkshire Dales, parked up on a hill, and of course Lou needed a wee, so opened the doors of the car, squatted in between them, and didn't realise that we were on a hill. So I was sat in the boot, could hear some cyclists coming up the road and coming up the hill, and they all of a sudden went silent, so I turned around and looked around the corner of the car, and all you could see is Lou's big white arse poking under the doors, squatting like a camel. So I'd say that's up there as one of the embarrassing ones. Lou's bra size, absolutely no idea. Pretty sure she doesn't know because I don't think any of her bras fit her. And she's always chopping and changing and moaning about them. So I'm gonna say a 34, 32C? 32C. We'll go with that. What do we most likely argue about? So at the minute, 100% it's the wedding. And it's usually Lou going, Danny, you've not done something. Danny, I'm doing all this wedding. Can you just sort this one thing out? So yeah, in fairness, she has done the majority of it. But yeah, I'd say the wedding's the big thing at the minute. So, three words to describe Lou. I put thoughtful, because she's very kind. She remembers absolutely everything and she manages to keep in contact with a million different people all at the same time, which I am horrendous at, as Hattie knows with me trying to submit this video. She's busy, so her mind is constantly going at 1,000 miles an hour. It's not as frantic as it was when we first met, but she's still doing a billion things at once. And the third word I'd say is generous. So she's very kind with her time or money, always spends things on and buys things for other people. So yeah, those are definitely the three words. Her best physical features, I would say, are her pins. So her legs, so she always says that she's got her mum's chicken legs, especially when she runs, which in fairness is true. But yeah, I'd say her legs are her best feature. Lou's best quality, I would say the fact that she will bend over backwards for everyone to make sure everyone else is happy. So if we ever have anyone over for dinner or we're seeing people, she will go above and beyond to make sure everyone's happy, be that going out to get a table setting to make sure the table looks nice so everyone's happy and make sure everyone's got 100,000 drinks. She's very kind, very thoughtful, and will put everyone else first before herself. So, who fancied who first? 100% Lou fancied me first. We're going with that. She won't admit it. She'll say that she just thought we were mates and we were just starting out by cooking each other dinner. But deep down, she knows she fancied me first. And our most romantic memory. We're not the most romantic couple, as everyone knows. I'd say the proposal was fairly romantic. It was on a beach, it was just us, it was lovely, we had a picnic, we had a nice time. I mean, Lou did pull a hat over her face, start crying and start snotting everywhere, so I mean that slightly spoiled the atmosphere and the ambiance. But no, I think generally that day she was floating on cloud nine and I was so relieved to get it done and dusted and that she said yes and it all worked out well. So I think our the proposal and our sort of enjoying the rest of the day was one of our most romantic memories. So there we are, questions done and dusted. Cheers, hats. Bye.